I want to discuss, no, not really discuss, I want to reveal something to you that's very important. What is it that's so important? It's about pagan Christianity. I'm not sure if you're aware of it, but pagan Christianity is the dominant cult on the earth right now, below the shadow government itself. The shadow government is the cult, and all the other sub-cults are subjected to the shadow government, which are the wizards together that worship the beast. And pagan Christianity is their biggest project. It has been their biggest project for centuries. There are many divisions within this project, but it's still their main project that they use to keep humanity enslaved in the negative. They have many other projects. Those are the other religions and the other philosophical streams that they provide. But pagan Christianity is their favorite. Now, why is pagan Christianity their favorite? Because pagan Christianity works so effectively. Pagan Christianity, it's like you go into a charlatan. The charlatan scams you. He tricks you into buying something that's completely worthless, but at the same time you think you won the jackpot. Forgive this noise in the background, I'm walking in public now in the city center. I just thought, let me just record this video now that I have inspiration. Okay, look. Pagan Christianity, let me repeat it, it's like going to a charlatan. You're not aware he's a charlatan, but he will trick you into spending all your money, that includes your savings accounts, all that you have, to get something that's completely worthless, but while you purchase it, you think you got the jackpot. That is what pagan Christianity is. Because pagan Christianity presents itself to be something it's completely not. It's completely the opposite. Pagan Christianity claims to follow Christ, right? So that means that it must be for life and abundance. So life and abundance must flow from pagan Christianity if they are truly following Christ. But hold on a minute. You see many pagan Christians dying of cancer. You see many pagan Christians in many struggles, too many struggles. You see pagan Christians going through the same stuff as people in the world, and they are subject to the same limitations as those in the world. Yet, pagan Christianity has this elite amongst them who runs the pagan Christians. Well, I don't want to hurt your feelings, but hold on a minute. Christ never installed an elite. The 12 disciples were intended to be servants unto mankind, especially those that would be redeemed from mankind, and their position of authority would only be to serve the people. The wealth ought to be distributed fairly and equally amongst the believers, that everyone would operate in prosperity. And everyone would contribute to the prosperity of the believing community. That is real life and abundance. But do you see this in pagan Christianity? No. You see a lot of things that go against this. So really, pagan Christianity is fake. But there's power behind it. And remember, if it's fake, but there's power behind it, then the power is not from Christ. Okay, let me repeat that, because some of you may need to hear this clearly. If something is fake, but there's power behind it, then the power is not from Christ. Because Christ is not going to empower something that's deceptive. It's not going to empower something that's going to destroy you in the long run. Pagan Christianity is the main project of the enemy in keeping people in bondage. Pagan Christianity, when you evaluate it carefully, is rooted in rejection. Rejection is a mental force that everyone is struggling with. All unbelievers do. And everyone was an unbeliever before they became born again. It has to do with the fallen state of man. Rejection is a mental construct people grow into because people want to avoid pain. And rejection is something everyone needs to be delivered from. Even in the world, amongst unbelievers, they realize that rejection is a problem. They can get relief from rejection, but they can't be delivered. Well, if pagan Christianity was really rooted in Christ, then it would walk in Christ's yes, amen towards us, each and every one of us. Christ, yes and amen. So Christ's double confirmation to us. There is no rejection in Christ. But hold on a minute. Pagan Christianity keeps telling you, yes, you're saved by grace, but oh dear, you need to hold on, you need to prove, you do this. Hold on a minute. You first they give you a security, at the same time it comes out of security they just gave onto you. What's that? You're being bewitched. When someone tells you something to make you at ease, at the same time they give you unease, to hold on to the ease they just gave onto you, you've been bewitched. That is what pagan Christianity does. And here's the thing. Pagan Christianity has many warlocks, witches, and even wizards operating freely in it in the name of Christ. People don't even recognize them. Because pagan Christianity is a counterfeit. And people are so used to the counterfeit that they can't realize it's a counterfeit. That's also a reason why it's dangerous. But what I said about rejection, just think about it. If you had, for example, a doctor, let's say you had a lot of pain in your stomach, you went to the doctor, and the doctor told you you have a terminal illness. Of course, you wouldn't be happy. You shouldn't be. So now you want to get rid of the sickness, right? Okay, that's good. But you come to another doctor who's higher than the previous one, and he tells you, you know what? You are healed, you're cured, but every weekend you need to come here at the practice to take some shot to remain healthy. And you think he's a doctor, he knows better, you trust him, so you do it. 5 years later, you keep going to the same place every weekend because you can't go on holidays because you need to be there every weekend. Someone asks you, why can't you go on holidays? Why can't you invest in other stuff? Then you say that you need to go to a doctor's practice every weekend to get a shot to remain healthy so that you won't die. And the individual asks you who pays for it. You say, I do, because I need to be healthy. And you tell the whole story of the pain in your stomach and the terminal illness and all of that. And the individual tells you, listen to yourself. If the doctor told you you are cured, then why do you need to keep coming there to get medicine against something you're already cured from? And then suddenly, you realize, hold on a minute, this doesn't add up at all. Your eyes are opened. That's how it is with pagan Christianity. They come with a threat that's not biblically founded, that goes against the gospel. They convince you it's true by turning you into believing it. And now that you have anxiety because of it, they come with a solution, and this solution keeps you trapped in seeking relief from a threat that doesn't even exist, which is condemnation. You get what I'm saying here? So pagan Christianity is rooted in rejection. I dare to say all religion is rooted in rejection, but in pagan Christianity, it's so obvious it centers around rejection. And look at this carefully. And don't take this wrong what I'm saying here. Pagan Christianity, if you're not careful, it will turn you into a narcissist. Or, at its best, it will make you narcissistic. You won't turn into a narcissist, but you will be very narcissistic. Because just think about it. For there to be safe relationships, there needs to be safety. Because without safety, you can't have relationships. If I am going to the supermarket, I'm going there because I trust that I can be safe there. I expect the people there to behave so that nobody would just attack me or anything like that. If I didn't have that basic trust that nobody would harm me, I would not go to the supermarket. Straight up. If I am and I have a friendship with someone, I expect a certain level of safety over there, or else there wouldn't be any friendship. Okay, apart from friendship, I won't even want contact with anyone if there's no safety over there. Safety is very important. Safety and security. But pagan Christianity keeps convincing you that there is no security unless you keep working hard for it. So they're keeping you in a state of anxiety, or which is a state of fear. And in a state of anxiety, you can't think straight, you can't feel well. This will affect all your human relationships, including your marriage, how you relate to opposite sex, how you relate to your friends, how you relate to strangers. And this will cause you to be constantly focused on yourself to look for your own safety. So you're constantly looking for number one. And this happens to you without you being aware of it. You grow into it. You will not notice it, but others will notice it. And this may even suck the joy out of your life. But you think you have joy because you go to church every Sunday and you're praising the Lord over there. Look, this video is not against people that attend church. This video is not against pagan Christians themselves. Because there are millions of pagan Christians who are not even aware they are deceived, they are trapped. I'm talking to those that are alert, who can see these things. Pagan Christianity is very dangerous. And that's why I do know some pagan Christians. Most of the pagan Christians I knew, they all blocked me, all threw me away, all became like enemies unto me when I kept agreeing with Christ. There are pagan Christians I know, I have contact with them occasionally, but I leave it at that. Because look, you cannot be part of a narcissist structure without it affecting you. I'm not saying you're becoming a narcissist yourself, but it will affect you. And once you are affected, the enemy can then use you, and you're not even aware of it. I've noticed, and maybe you've noticed also, that among pagan Christians in general, you can't decree fate. For example, if you say that no believer ought to be sick, that sickness shouldn't even exist among believers, some will look at you, and some will even attack you. Seriously, they will attack you. Or if you begin to decree financial abundance upon yourself every day, they'll tend to think, why do you love money so much? Or who do you think you are? I mean, anytime you begin to agree with Christ and decree life and abundance, many pagan Christians, they can't handle it. Why? Because they're rooted in rejection. And you can't operate in life and abundance once you're rooted in rejection. Because rejection is against life and abundance. Because rejection is anti-Christ. Rejection itself doesn't even exist. But that thought construct that we hold on to makes it seem as if it's a real thing. So look, how can someone... this is just a question I'm asking you here. If you, for example, are a soldier in the Dutch Navy, or let's say you're a Marine in the Dutch Navy, for example, and you're sent out to combat some pirates at Somalia, your mission is to protect the European ships and also Somali ships over there. You're not supposed to get involved with the pirates directly. Neither should you fellowship with them. You shouldn't even be able to fellowship with them because you're with your fellow Marines on a mission. What if you have a Marine that takes off his Marine uniform, dives into the pirates community, he has fellowship with them, he even agrees with them, he even attacks several ships with them, and man, he totally doesn't care about his fellow Marines. He's not undercover or anything like that. He does it just to be at ease, just because he doesn't want to be in the fight. What's going to happen to that Marine once he returns to the Netherlands? He's in big trouble. Now, the Netherlands doesn't have the death penalty anymore. But in some countries, if you do that, that's treason. You can get a death penalty for it because you endangered your own people and your fellow troops that were with you. Now, let's say that Dutch Marine would say, you know what, I know I operate as a pirate, I thought as a pirate, I agreed with pirates, but deep in my heart, I am a true Dutchman and I love the Netherlands, I love my country, I love Europe. Anyone who would hear this in the court of law would declare this guy is insane, because they would say to him clearly, listen, you know very well how dangerous those people are. How can you agree with them against the Netherlands, endanger the Netherlands, endanger European interests, yet at the same time you claim to be all for Europe and that Europe is all for you? That doesn't add up, right? well, in a far worse way pagan Christianity is. People there are conditioned to operate in rejection, yet they keep claiming that deep down inside they're completely free in Christ. But they don't agree with Christ at all. What? That should be a rejection. You should be shocked by that, but that's what pagan Christianity is. That's why pagan Christianity confuses so many people. And that's why many of those pagan Christians confuse you when you hang out with them, because they operate in confusion. They live under confusion. They agree with the confusion. I'm telling you, nobody can agree with Christ yet operate in rejection. Either you're born again, but still need to live from that thing of rejection, or you're not born again at all, but you are deceived in thinking that you're saved and you're operating from rejection. In any way, nobody can operate in rejection and be free in Christ at the same time. Because being free in Christ automatically burns away that demonic stronghold of rejection. How can you operate in the fire of the Holy Spirit and yet that counterfeit weak fire of the demonic is still comfortable around you? That's not possible. Look, I'm not attacking pagan Christians here. I used to be trapped briefly by pagan Christianity also. I used to be enthusiastic about pagan Christianity. I mean, I wasn't even aware it was pagan. But I sensed, but deep down inside, I realized something didn't add up. And I did not deny reality, so I began to find out what was wrong. And man, because I know what paganism is, I figured out quickly that whole thing is of the devil. I'm not saying all those people are of the devil, because there are people who are true believers who are trapped by it, many of them. Just understand that pagan Christianity is a cheap, debased, stinking, filthy counterfeit that's praised by the world, even by unbelievers. And look at this. If unbelievers who are in darkness look up to something and want to learn from something, okay, occasionally it can happen that as human beings, they truly see the light and they want to go after the light. That happens, okay? I'm not saying that's not possible. But if multitudes of unbelievers who hold on to that there is no God get inspired by something that promotes that same God they are against whom they fight, because they hold on to that there is no God because they don't want the idea of a God. They want a godless universe. So why would people that fight against the idea of the existence of a God, why would they seek inspiration from people that promote the same God which is against their own interest? So even those so-called atheists are inconsistent, are confused. But I'm not going to talk about atheists here now. Atheists in general, I'm speaking about. If people who are in confusion look up to you and hold on to you for a long period of time, they begin to question whether you are in agreement with Christ or not. People, let me say like this. Let's say you live in Spain, and you have people who are Republicans. They hate the kingdom of Spain. They want the Republic of Spain. They're so against the idea of a king. They will a republic. And now you are a so-called royalist, and they're supporting you. That's confusion over there. If they are Republicans, yet they support you as a royalist, they are confused themselves. They are contradicting themselves. And many, if not, I'm not going to say all, but I would say 99.99999% of unbelievers are contradicting themselves. They have no other option because they're lost. But if people that are lost, who are contradicting themselves, if they keep praising you for a long period of time, honestly, if the world loves you, oh, you're in trouble. So why is pagan Christianity loved? Why is pagan Christianity upheld so high? Well, now look at this. Pagan Christianity is a counterfeit. You have the real biblical revelation that has affected mankind for the good. And pagan Christianity must take credit for it. So people can be confused by that. Okay, I can understand that. But it should be obvious by now that there is a counterfeit of biblical revelation. And that's pagan Christianity. There are even books that came out about the subject. But yet people just don't want to see the difference. Look, for those that agree with Christ, keep agreeing with him. Christ never said it would be easy following him. Christ never said it would be easy to walk my faith. I'm telling you, keep on going. And by all means, as far as it depends on you, stay away from pagan Christianity and pagan Christians, I'm not telling you to turn on them, but realize they're operating in confusion based in rejection. So do not permit them to have too much say in your affairs, because they will speak confusion in your life, in your affairs. They will release demons on you, and they're not even aware they're doing it. That's how confused they are. Don't hate them, don't turn on them, just know what you're dealing with. You can pray for them for their deliverance, but do not have fellowship with them. That being said, agree with Christ and be at peace.